Hi, in this video, I'll show you how to animate Excel charts in a PowerPoint slide. So there may be instances where you want to put Excel charts like column charts or pie charts into a PowerPoint, and you want to do a little animation to kind of focus in on certain areas. So here's an example of animating some of the column chart here. So if I go into blank slide, I click again, and I click the mouse key again, it just shows the data for May here. If I click again, it's going to show the data for June. So this is actually just a Excel chart that's in PowerPoint. Now another example is, let's say we have this pie chart and we want to kind of focus on one particular pie slice. And if I click the button, it will explode that particular pie slice for apples, apple pie, out a little bit. So that's another example of how we can animate a chart within an Excel chart within PowerPoint. So let's see how this could be done. So I'm out of presentation view. I'm going to go ahead and go into a blank slide, and I'm going to bring in some charts from Excel. So here I am in Excel. Let me go ahead and bring this particular chart in. Oh, by the way, this chart is built off of this table. We have this table here. See, if I click into the chart, you notice that the table is there. All I need to do is just select the table, Control C to copy. Go ahead and go into a blank slide and press Control V to paste. And we have the Excel chart. You can notice that the chart tools contextual menu is on. So basically, it is a embedded Excel chart there. So what I can do is also I'm going to go ahead and bring in the pie chart I have here in slide 2. Let me go and select that. Control C to copy. You can notice that this is built off that table there. Let me go back into PowerPoint and go into my other slide here, Control V to paste. Right, so now I have those particular two charts. Let me go ahead and go into the column chart here and expand it out a little bit. Let me go ahead and expand it out a little bit so it becomes a little bit more clear to see. So all you need to do here is what the chart selected. We'll go under animations and let's select some kind of animation for it. Let's just say it go ahead and flies in, and we'll have it fly in from the bottom's fine. So once that's done, we'll go ahead and bring in the animation pane to go ahead and select it. Because right now the whole thing is flying in, but we want to have it separately fly in. Let's say we want to have May data fly in first and then have June data fly in. So let me go ahead and click on the animation pane. So right now it is seeing the whole chart as an object that it's going to animate on, and we'll want to separate that. So we want to go ahead and click on the drop down, go to Effect Options, and in the effect options, go under Chart Animation tab here, and what we want to do is we want to have it not as one object, but let's say we want to have a series because we have the May series and we have the June series. So if I click on that and click OK, and then go ahead and preview, it previews it. It kind of plays it for me. You see that it already does it. So let me go ahead and just go into slideshow view, and you can see that it's doing it. So it's first it's a blank. I click again, the chart comes up, and I click again, and then May comes up, and then June comes up. So that is the animation of the individual elements for the chart. Let me go ahead and get out of slideshow view. And the reason why the chart showed up first, or the background showed up first, is I had that there's a lot of things that you can go ahead and change. So we go back into the animation options there. We have our group chart by series, which I did, but also we had the start animation by drawing the chart background. So it includes that background as one of the things you can click on. So if I didn't want that, I just want to have the chart background static and draw the animation for the other elements of the chart. I can just deselect that and click OK. And now you notice that the chart background is already there and everything else gets put in. Incidentally, there's this drop down here so you can go ahead and see what chart elements are available for you to animate. So this is the first one, which is the May one, and the second one is the June one. Let's say you didn't want to click on there, you want to click for the first one. You can use the individual, you can select the individual ones, and maybe I want to have this after previous and maybe make that a second, right? And so you can do it that way. So if I click, go ahead and go into slideshow view, you notice the first time it's blank, I click the mouse button, and then after that, a second later on, the other animation comes up. So that's the example for the column chart. The next example is for the pie chart, and where we have some movement outside where we're exploding the pie. Let me go ahead and increase this. So once that's done, what I want to do is I want to have the effect where I am I have a motion path, so I'm going to move it out. I'm going to select this particular motion path, the lines. And so what I want to do is have it moved up to, let me go ahead and do the same example where I have this blue slice move up to the right. So let me go ahead and move this. So right now it's moving the whole thing as is, but I'm going to go ahead first and move the motion of where I want it to up to the upper right. So once I click that and click play, you notice the whole thing moves. So what I want to do now is I want to separate everything. So let me go ahead and click on that and go to Effect Options and then go to Chart Animation, not as one object, but as a category. So each category. Let me go ahead and also select it where it's not going to draw the background as part of the animation. So I'm going to go and click OK. Okay, so now I'm going to have to separate everything. So you'll notice that there's one, two, and three animations. So that's going to be, if I click play, you notice that it went ahead and applied the animation to all three categories, the apples, oranges, and plums. What I want to do is I just want to have it on apples. So I'll go ahead and click the drop down here. And I'm going to remove it for, let's see which one goes first, right? I think it was apples that went first. So that's the first one. You see the second one's a little more darker gray. The third one is a little darker gray. So I just need to remove the other two. So I'm going to go ahead and select two and three here and just click remove. And that one gets removed. And now when I click play, or probably better that, let me go ahead and go into slideshow view. If I go ahead and go into slideshow view and I click the mouse to play it, now you notice that that is the only slice that gets animated of the pie chart. So let me go ahead and press escape to get out of here. So as with most animations and most capabilities in PowerPoint, you can go a little bit overboard. Let's say, for example, we wanted to have this go ahead and change that and have, instead of flying in, maybe we wanted to swivel, and maybe we wanted to kind of do that with the other one too, and with the other one selected, we can go ahead and maybe change that to swivel too. Let me go ahead and go into slideshow view. And now you notice that when I click, you'll see that it swivels. So this is sometimes a little bit overboard, but it just depends if you want to have some, if there's something whimsical or something kind of funny that you have in your slide, you wanted to give some impression of a whimsy nature to it, that might be appropriate. But of course, with a lot of these animations, it's good to be judicious and use it wisely and not get it too far out there. So that's the way that you can create or animate the Excel chart within your PowerPoint deck. So I hope that helps. Thanks for watching.